Holy Spirit, guide me, lead me, your will, not my will, in Jesus' name. Amen. Hello everyone, God bless you all for watching. It's been long and I'm glad. I thank God that I'm here today for the fact that he has brought me. I know I've been wondering why I didn't come, and I promised that I'm going to be coming at least every Saturday. But it is because I was not yet given a message by God. But today I was able, God has given me a message, and I thank God for the fact that he has brought me, for that I'm here today. So I miss you people so much, and today I've come with a very interesting message. Most of you know this message. It is titled "The Fruits of the Holy Spirit." That is fruits of the Holy Spirit. So I'm going to sing a song, and then I'll continue from there. The fruits of the Spirit are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. The fruits of the Spirit are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. So we're going to go to the book of Galatians chapter 5 verse 22. I told you people can get a physical Bible, or you can download the Bible app, but I'll prefer if you just get the physical Bible. It's better. That's what I'm going to be using today. So Galatians chapter 5 verse 22, it says, "But the Spirit produces love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, humility, and self-control." I'm just going to start from verse 16, and I'll read the part that is standing out on this case. The Spirit and human nature. This is Galatians chapter 5 verse 16 to 26, and it says, "What I say is this: let the Spirit direct your lives, and you will not satisfy the desires of the human nature. For what our human nature wants is opposed to what the Spirit wants, and what the Spirit wants is opposed to what our human nature wants. These two are enemies, and this means that you cannot do what you want to do. If the Spirit leads you, then you are not a subject to the law. What human nature does is quite plain. It shows itself in immoral, filthy, and indecent actions, in worship of idols and witchcraft. People become enemies and they fight. They become jealous, angry, and ambitious. They separate into parties and groups. They are envious, get drunk, have orgies, and do other things like this. I warn you now, as I have before, those who do these things will not possess the kingdom of God. But the Spirit produces love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, humility, and self-control. There is no law against such things as this. And those who belong to Christ Jesus have put to death their human nature with all its passions and desires. The Spirit has given us life. He must also control our lives. We must not be proud or irritate one another or be jealous of one another." This is from the Good News Bible. I can read again the part that is standing out. "But the Spirit produces love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, humility, and self-control." This is Galatians chapter 5 verse 22 to 23. "The fruits of the Spirit are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law." So I'm going to talk about each of them. The first one is love. As the last message that I preached, it was about you shall love the Lord that make it all, and you should know that you should love yourself as you love your neighbor as you love yourself. Sorry. Joy. True joy comes from, if you go to Matthew, Yes, Matthew chapter 5 verse 3 to 12. This is where true happiness is. You can read this and this will also tell you like the true happiness doesn't come from all these worldly things, all this material wealth. It comes from the Beatitudes. You're going to read from Matthew chapter 5 verse 3 to 12. Patience, you should... let me give an example. Let's say you've gone, for example, with your mother, like to the supermarket, and you're like, "Mom, today can we go and buy pizza?" Then she'll be like, "Okay, just wait." And then you, cause you're just impatient, you're like, "Mom, when are we not to go? We're not going now." Then she'll be like, "Be patient." As in, don't even. In it may not only be in these such cases like this, but in all circumstances, please just always be patient. Don't rush to do things. Just do it with patience and just take your time. Kindness, all of you know the meaning of kindness. You can also, for example, you're in your car, you're traveling, and you see a beggar on the road. And he's asking you politely, "Can I just have 5 shillings? Because this will really help me." And then you're like, "Ah, no, I don't have today." But maybe you have that. Maybe you even have more than that 5 shillings. Should I give that person that 5 shillings? And the money that remains, you can use it. But then give that person that 5 shillings, and that is what we call kindness, being kind to one another. When somebody tells you something rude, for example, somebody tells you "shame on you," you tell them "God bless you," and God will reward you because of this. If you talk bad back to them, of course this is going to be sinning, and this is not going to be what God wants you to do. This will not be God's will. So be kind to people. If somebody tells you "shame on you," tell them "God bless you." Goodness, we all know what is being good. I don't to see on that. Faithfulness. Always have faith in God. If, for example, your pastor, like for me, I'm in an online ministry with my family called Princess Belemzi Ministries, and I'll talk more about that lady. And she's a powerful man of God. God speaks to her, God speaks through her. I mean, it is powerful. It's an online church, so basically you don't need to, it's not a physical church, it's just an online church where anyone can join it. But this place is very powerful. It's full of power. If you notice in one of my videos, like the 11 minutes with Jesus, I had somewhere written Princess Belemzi Ministry School of Power. I'll talk more about that. Let me just, she's very powerful. Okay, faithfulness. For example, now they are in this ministry. Now this woman of God, for example, you're sick, right? For us in this ministry, we just don't go immediately to ask her, "Woman of God, can you please pray for me? I'm feeling this and this." No. She has prayers, like she has an audio for pray for water, where you pray for your water and you drink it. If you believe, have faith, you're going to be healed. So in this ministry, we don't really ask her for prayers. She has 3 minutes water, 12 minutes water. She has prayers again, almost prayers for everything. So if you're not feeling well, just go to those. We don't even need to go to hospital. If you just have faith and believe, this water is going to heal you, just as you believe. You don't need to go to hospital, because this might even be attacks, and attacks are not to be treated by their doctor. So you need to be treated by prayer, your faith in God, and yes, gentleness and self-control. Self-control, now this is something that stands out more in this. 1 minute. The fruits of the Holy Spirit are 9, and the gifts of the Holy Spirit are 1 minute, sorry. So I was saying the fruits of the Holy Spirit are 9, that is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Now, that was what I was going to preach today, and I hope you are blessed through it. You can just meditate on this scripture, Galatians chapter 5, verse 23. Now, if you have not accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, Please say this prayer after me. This is the salvation prayer. Father Lord, I come into your presence as a sinner. I confess all my sins. Please forgive me. I didn't know any better. I promise not to go back to my old ways. I believe that Jesus Christ came and died for me on the cross of Calvary so that my sins can be wiped away. I accept Jesus Christ as my Lord and personal Savior. Be the Lord over my life. I promise to serve you forever and ever. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Now, I was reading from Vindication Book, My Story as Told by God. This book is when God spoke through the mouth of Apostle Princess Belemzi, a woman of God from Princess Belemzi Ministry School of Power. God spoke through her mouth for almost 3 hours. You can imagine God speaking through someone's mouth. I know most of you might not believe this, but you have to believe, because if you don't believe this, you'll suffer consequences, because this is God. God is the one who spoke through her mouth, and it's all written in this book. And I read the salvation prayer from here at the back. I can show you. Here it is, salvation prayer. You can see clearly. Yes. So, this book, it's very powerful. You might be sick of, for example, COVID-19. And if you just hold this book and believe it, you will be healed instantly. And you need to go, if you go to hospital and when you're tested for COVID-19, it will test negative. And because of the power that is in this book, I'm even feeling hot right now, so I'm touching this book. Just only if you believe. You can't just get healed when you just touch it like that and you don't believe. So this is how it looks like. It's a very beautiful book. I'll also talk about this book, and you will get to know more about this woman of God and about this Vindication book. So this book is very powerful, and if you want this book, go to elevivepublishing.com, www.elevivepublishing.com. You can order it and you will get it. There's a soft copy and a hard copy. This is a soft copy. I'll talk more about it very soon in one of my videos. So thank you all so much for watching this video. I love you all. God bless you. Oh, 1 minute. Let us pray. Let us pray. Oh God, thank you for this day. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for the gift of protection. Oh God, your Jehovah Nissi, your Jehovah Jireh, your Jehovah Shaddai, your Alpha and Omega, your Lion of Judah. We thank you for everything that you have done unto our lives. If it wasn't for you, we wouldn't be here, dear Father. I pray to may forgive our sins in Jesus' name. That you may forgive us anything that I've done against. I will pray to me forgive us in Jesus' name. Oh God, for the ones who have watched this video, the ones who are going to watch this video, I pray to may bless them, that you may speak to them, that they have said the salvation prayer, that you may also deliver them and restore them fully in Jesus' name. And for this, in Jesus, we pray and believe. Amen. Thank you so much for watching this video. I love you. Bye.